So last year I went out and bought the Sony 100 to 400 G Master lens. And this has been my dream lens for a while. Ever since I started in photography, I've always had a strong interest in wildlife photography. And so I've tried a variety of different long lenses and different zoom lenses in the past, and this was always the dream. So when I finally got this lens, it lived up to my expectations. But this video, I wanna keep it short, and I just wanna go over some of my experiences that I've had with a variety of different long lenses on the Sony system, and what made me end up buying this lens. So stick around, and I'll try to give you lots of different examples from all of the lenses that I've used on the Sony system. So the first long lens I ever had access to was the 24 to 240 on the Sony camera system. And I love this lens. It's a great all-around lens. It's a super zoom. So it goes from 24, which is very wide on a full frame camera body, to 240, which is, you know, fantastic distance. And it's where I got to kind of get my feet wet when it came to wildlife photography. So it wasn't great for shooting birds, but for things like foxes and smaller mammals, this was a great lens. And it was where I really started getting more and more of an interest of shooting wildlife. This right here is the Sigma MC11 adapter. And I used this to mount my Sigma 150 to 600 telephoto lens to my Sony system. I was very excited when I got the Sigma 150 to 600, and it was a great lens. I took a lot of great photographs with that lens. The only issue that arose with that lens was that the autofocus wasn't very reliable. So although I was able to get extremely far reach, it was very hard for me to nail focus on shots that mattered. And the thing that sent me over the edge was when I was driving home, I ended up seeing a coyote. And coyotes are kind of a rare thing to see where I'm from. And I must have taken about 90 different shots. I was, you know, continuously shooting, and not one photo made focus. It was extremely disappointing, and it was the thing that sent me over the edge, because this had happened for a long time with the Sigma lens. I love the Sigma lens, but there were a lot of moments where the inconsistency would drive me crazy. I would take hundreds of shots and maybe a dozen would be in focus. And I feel like it's not necessarily the Sigma's fault. It was more so the fact that the lens was made for a Canon system and I was using the MC11 adapter. And when it comes to any sort of zoom lens, typically focus really matters, because whether it's sports or wildlife, you have to nail focus, because you really only have about 20 seconds to get the shot, or less, sometimes only like 2 to 3 seconds. So, especially with wildlife, because they can poke their head out and as soon as they see you, they're back in the woods. And that was the experience that sent me over the edge and made me say, you know what, if I'm going to be serious about wildlife photography, if I'm going to invest in travel so that I can go, you know, take wildlife photography at Yellowstone or Yosemite or in Banff, Alberta, the last thing I want is to take a lens that's not going to nail focus when, you know, that rare moment happens. And because of that, that's why I bought the Sony 100 to 400 G Master lens. I needed something that was reliable, something that if I did experience that rare moment, it wouldn't be a missed opportunity. So ever since I bought the 100 to 400 G Master lens, the hit rate has been phenomenal. So I don't expect it to be perfect. I don't expect to get a 100% hit rate on every photo that I take, but I do have to say that it's gone up substantially since selling the Sigma and upgrading to the 100 to 400 G Master lens. I use this lens primarily for photography. So in this video, I'm gonna be putting lots of different photo examples on the screen, but I don't have that many footage examples because I don't really use this lens for taking video. I use this lens for photography almost all of the time. And it's usually handheld photography. The majority of the moments that I get to capture are usually split second. So an eagle is flying overhead, or a fox just kind of appears and then disappears into the woods. I only have split seconds to react. So carrying around a tripod or a monopod is more difficult, because I'm usually relying on those split second moments overall, my experience with the 100 to 400 G Master lens has been quite positive. And it should be positive. It's a very expensive lens. So those are kind of the expectations you have going into buying a G Master lens. I will say this though, the 24 to 240 lens was also a fantastic lens and a great starter lens for any sort of wildlife photography. I've taken a lot of great shots with that lens, but I wanted something that was a little bit longer. The Sigma lens was a fine lens. I loved the images that turned out, but I just found that for the amount of photos that I was taking versus the amount of shots that actually hit focus, I just felt like I needed something that was more reliable, especially if I was going to be traveling or paying to go somewhere and take wildlife photos. The last thing you want is to, miss that one shot that, comes out of nowhere. One thing that I would ask myself before buying this lens again is, what type of subjects do I plan on shooting? This lens is fantastic for birds and quick moving subjects. The Sigma worked out fine for any sort of animal that was just sitting there. So if you want birds in flight, then this lens is going to be fantastic, but you can get amazing shots with the Sigma 150 to 600. So if that's your price range, I would go for it and just upgrade later on. I was able to sell my lens for a pretty similar price to what I bought it for. I think it was just a couple hundred dollars less that I ended up selling it for. So you can always upgrade, but I just wanted to give you my take on the 100 to 400 lens. And hopefully this video was somewhat helpful. I know it's not like really that detailed when it comes to the tech specs, but you can get those anywhere. I just wanted to give one man's opinion on the 100 to 400 lens. Thank you for sticking through to the end. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, and I'd love if you subscribed. I'll see you in the next video.